Hello, I'm Graham Horton. Welcome to today's video. Now, this is the second in a series of videos I'm making called Graham's Quick Build. Now, these are quick build articles for those that are interested in electronics and applying it to their photography. In the first one, we looked at the synchronization device, which allowed you to synchronize the audio and video with cameras that don't have an internal audio recording input, such as the FZ8082. Now, in today's video, I want to look at a variable attenuator, which allows you to use line level output devices and record it directly into your camera. So, for example, if you've got, say, the Amazon Echo and you wanted to record from that, it's got a 500 millivolt output, where our cameras normally have got a maximum input of something like between 5 and 10 millivolts. So there's a tremendous overload. So we need to attenuate that output to get us down to the correct mic level. It's also the same with things like these pocket recorders. If you recorded on one of these or using them as a direct audio input from the output device here, you need to attenuate that to get it down to mic level. So that's what this video is around, and I'm going to show you a circuit that I've put together here which will allow you to attenuate something like 20 dB or 100 times gain reduction. On the desk here you can see it's a very, very simple circuit. This is just the one element of a stereo circuit, so for something like a stereo input for our cameras, you'll be duplicating each of these circuits. So it's basically a potential divider circuit. We've got here a 50k pot, which is the one which will allow us to vary the input, which is these two here for the stereo circuitry. We've got a 1k here in series with that pot, so that if we're in the minimum position, which would put the full voltage onto the output circuit, then we're not going to load down the output into 470 ohms. So that 1k there is just to provide a load once you've got this set to minimum. But normally you'll be using this something like halfway or three quarter way to get the attenuation you need for the output. The actual divider circuit is this part plus this resistor, so there is our 20 dB reduction. Most of the mic input circuits are providing a DC bias for electric condenser microphones, so to provide a buffer between this device here and the input, I've got a 2.2 microfarad capacitor here, which allows the signal to pass through but doesn't interfere with the DC bias for any microphone. So this, you wouldn't hear the movement on the pot while we've got a DC bias. And the 1K load is there if you're going to be using this with, say, a smartphone, which needs to see something like between 1K and 2K input impedance before it will switch over into a recording mode. So that's the reason for that 1K. So a very, very simple circuit. Here's it built into a small box, but it's managed to sub-miniaturize this by using smaller potentiometers inside a smaller case. So everything in this device I've packed into this small case. Inside I've got a very simple circuit, which is what we've seen on the schematic here. So the resistors and the capacitor and the two 50k pots to provide us our attenuation. Now, the only thing you have to watch out for if you're building something like this, which is going to be using mic level 5 millivolts input, is not to use cables which don't have a screen. So this particular cable here, which I cut, you see we've got the red, the white and the yellow, which would be the standard screen tip and ring for a connection like this, TRS. It doesn't have a screen, so that could be susceptible to hum, another electrical interference. So it's best to use a screen cable, and all the cables that I've used on this device are screen. So use a screen cable when you're constructing this device. Just provide you with that 20 dB gain, and here's some examples of some line level outputs which are of the order of 500 millivolts into my mixer here, which is mic level, and you can hear the quality of that audio input using this stage. If you find the bass response isn't quite enough for what you want it for, normally for a vocal, the 2.2 microfarad that's here on the circuitry, 2.2 will give you enough low pass, but if you're finding your bass is lacking, then you're going to up this to something like 10 microfarads without any problems at all. But generally 2.2 is good enough for speech. Right, for this first test, I'm going to be using this Tascam DR40, using the XY mics on here as the input, and switch over to that and you'll be able to hear the quality of the audio passing through this attenuator with that 2.2. Let's switch over to that device. So now you're hearing the audio coming from the attenuator box. It's a little hot, so I'm going to just adjust the level down a little bit. So we'll just turn this down from, say, 7 to 6 on both channels. And we can see we're now in the yellow on the mixer, so that looks fine. I'll give you a moment's silence just to see what the background noise level's like. And that's showing about minus 50 dB on the level meter on my Andy Cine monitor here, which is monitoring the output from the device. So about minus 50 dB from this device. Here's a sample of an output I took from the Amazon Echo. And again, it's a line output, so you can drive other speakers, etc. So this is a recording of the Amazon Echo device.
Right now in Horwich, England, it's 4 degrees Celsius with cloudy skies. Today's forecast has rainy weather, with a high of 6 degrees and a low of minus 2 degrees.
Now you could of course use the output from your smartphone if you use the required dongle. So with the iPhone 15 Pro Max here, Type-C dongle, so you could use that. With the DAC that's in here, you're going to get an audio output. So again, you could plug this device into the mixer and give you a sample. Give you a few seconds of a clip for a audio on here, and we'll be able to see the quality from the iPhone. So that was just a few seconds recording using the iPhone 15 Pro Max. And now here's a voice memo again recorded on that, so we don't get a copyright strike for using commercial music. So now is a sample of the output from a wireless lavalier system. The transmitter is here, there is the receiver. The Kimafun KM50-1, slightly high output from this device, so attenuating it with the variable attenuator to give us the correct level. So this is the Kimafun wireless microphone passing through the variable attenuator. And again, the noise floor is about 48 or 49 dB. So you've seen how this variable attenuator can be used with line output devices to enable you to get the correct levels for recording, either into pocket recorders that have got a mic input, or into your smartphone if you use a TRS to TRRS adapter with your dongles. And we've seen how you can take outputs from phones into the device as well. So hopefully you'll find that of use if you're into electronics and you want to build your own little devices. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. I will put this circuit diagram in the electronics for photographers page of my photo blog, and you'll find a link to that in the video description below. If you like what you see with this mini series, why not hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and you'll be advised when I upload another project in this series. So until then, thanks for watching, please do take care, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.